talk a little bit about that, your passion with us, and I'll be with you. Welcome, Dave.
Thanks a lot. So, yeah. I started Aikido right about when I started Crane, I think, and I've been doing it ever since. I'm 18 now, so I've been doing it for about 13 years. Aikido is a pretty young martial art. It was founded by this guy, Morihei Ueshiba, in Japan. And what he did is he sort of looked at all the other martial arts in Japan, and he found that there was something missing. He found that the thing that was missing was sort of kindness and gentler attitude towards martial arts. So he made Aikido with the intention of sort of making a martial art that whose purpose was not to destroy your opponent, but to create a win-win situation. Okay? It's a completely defensive martial art. There are no attacks in Aikido. They're only defensive. And the idea is that when someone comes in and attacks, you create a win-win situation for you and your opponent. You don't hurt your opponent, and your opponent doesn't hurt you. Okay? And that can be done in a variety of ways. And very glad to have my old dojo here. They should be coming out any moment. Santa Barbara Aikido, Aikido Santa Barbara. It's down on Kota and Memphis. And we're going to show you guys some Aikido today. And it should be fun. So just starting off, there are two basic parts to training in Aikido. You learn how to throw, and you learn how to take a throw. Okay? Learning how to throw is very important. Learning how to take a throw is also very important. Okay? And they're both integral parts of what Aikido is. You can't have one without the other. You can't throw someone without learning how to take a throw yourself. Okay? So it's everything from the most basic throw, the basic roll, right? So if I'm walking here and I stumble, whoops, I'm just going to roll like that. Okay? When I punch. Okay? If I'm walking and I lose my balance backwards, I'm just going to roll like that. I'm punch. Okay? And then if someone, if I, you know, attack someone and they throw me really hard, take a like that, and it's fine, it doesn't hurt. It just takes a lot of practice. Okay? So, hopefully what we're going to show you today is some interesting, what we call techniques, right? So, technique is when someone comes in and attacks me and I throw them, and they take a kemi and they're not hurt. And let me see if these guys are ready. Hey, you guys ready? Alright, come on out. What you're going to see now is what happens before every Aikido class. The whole class comes in. By the way, this is Sensei Bill Stock, chief instructor of Santa Barbara Aikido. His wife is Geraldine, the other chief instructor of Santa Barbara Aikido. Okay, so let's start. Thanks. Franchesco, you want to start? He's going to defend himself.
Okay.
What about? see, we all have these sort of skirt things on. Sure how hot it was. So at this level, you sort of just respond, and then whatever happens sort of happens. But when you're beginning, you have sort of a choreography, a set step, what you must do and what you cannot do. The thing you will find for every technique, is if he's coming in this way, he's going to punch me. He's going to get off the line. That's the thing that happens in every single technique. And I can get off the line that way, this way, you know. I can do a lot of things. That's what's consistent with everything. And then you just change the technique. Does that answer your question?
Yes,
please. Yeah.
Who's been doing it the longest?
Who's been doing it the longest?
Notice that first move wasn't a block, but it was a sidestep, or for many of them, using the other person as a strength or a part of that.
Yeah, that's the other fundamental basis of Aikido. That's why Aikido is so self-defensive. Is you use the attacker's energy against them. So if someone attacks me, like Travis. Someone attacks me like Travis, right? He's really big and stuff. How am I going to get him down if he tries to punch me? Okay? I just use his energy against him. So it ends up turning out that there's very little upper body strength involved. It's all alignment and positioning. Background, we had Laser make that for us last night. Yeah?
Is it fun?
Oh, it's really fun. Flying through the air like that? It's awesome. And throwing other people really hard is really good. Yeah? Everyone here is a black belt except for Franchesco. But he's pretty close, as you can see. Pretty close. Everyone here is a first degree black belt except for Francesco, and the two senseis there are fifth degree black belts. Yeah? Yeah?
How are you?
Hey!
You said that it's a good idea to prevent injury for yourself and for your adversary. It seems that it would be very easy to break someone's arm, particularly. Could that be a possible outcome?
It could be, but when you're training in a dojo, especially an Aikido dojo, you learn how to be sensitive to the other person's skill level. So if Francesco comes in and attacks me, and he's just started today, right, and he grabs my hand, which is like the basic Aikido attack, okay, and I do this technique on him, now I could break his arm right here, but the thing in Aikido is we make a conscious choice not to, so instead we turn it back into him. As Francesco becomes more advanced, he can take the abuse. So, I can come here, and then, in order for him not to hurt his arm, not necessarily break it, not hurt it, he has to take a break. Okay, so it gets more advanced. We always adapt to whoever you're throwing. We don't want to hurt. Yeah.
What is the significance of your posture, your skirt? Why do you add that over?
It's a sign that you've reached a certain level in your
Aikido.
And traditionally it was worn by samurai to sort of distinguish them from other troops in the battlefield so that they could fight each other. But in Aikido it's just a sign that you can take really good falls and not get hurt, and then you can throw really hard and not hurt someone. Yeah.
There's no kicking in Aikido.
There are the only attacks we do in Aikido are, how shall I put this, sort of training attacks. They're attacks meant to get us used to receiving an attack, blending with the attack, and throwing the opponent. There's no actual kicking.
Are there any actual like competitions, like do you go out
Good question. Aikido is completely non-competitive. There are no Aikido competitions because of the nature of it, right? You can't attack someone with Aikido. So how are you supposed to compete? If you can't attack someone, you can't compete, right? It's a non-competitive thing. And that's a really good thing because everyone learns at their own pace. It's completely, I mean, it's a tough workout, but it's not as sort of pressured as some of the other workouts. Yeah?
Does Nick Boyle take drums too?
Yes.
And what belt is he?
Okay, he may be with someone else, but I'm sure he takes Aikido and he's with him somewhere.
Does Aikido help you in any other sports?
Oh yeah, it's great for reflexes. Someone attacking really quickly, you have to react. It's great for balance, because even though it looks like we're losing our balance all the time, it takes a lot of balance for the person who's throwing to stay on their feet. And it's a great overall body workout. Like I said, it doesn't emphasize the upper body, but it really works out your entire body when you're flying through the air and you have to land correctly, and then get back up and get thrown again. It helps every sport you can possibly think of, I think, except for maybe golf. Oh, yeah, see, and then get your hips involved, and then, you know, you start getting balls by. Yeah. How long does it take you to learn how to do it? Well, about a day. You start learning when you come to the dojo, right? I mean, like, everyone here, even though we've all reached a certain level, are still working on it. Okay? So we're all still learning a lot of things. I know I learn a lot every time I work out. So when you go into the dojo, you learn how to do it really quickly. You work really hard. Yeah, we have time for one or more.
Today, practice.
Don't do that.
But I'm sure it's a